Hi Sagittarius, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. And this is your monthly forecast for October 2012. Sagittarians, we start this month with a very interesting shift. We have Saturn and she's moving after 28 and a half years into Scorpio. She moves out of Libra where she's been resting for the last 2.5 years. Now every time that Saturn moves and she shifts to a particular house, this basically talks of a lot of lessons that we all require. Lessons also more on a soul level. Things that require change and no longer introspection or thinking or planning. Saturn is all about change. For you Sagittarians, this shift is happening in your 12th house. The 12th house is all about behind the scenes. It's about spirituality. It is also about a lot of introspection. It is about things that are or projects or thoughts which are more on the background. It is not really more on the surface piece of it. It also speaks about past. It speaks about your childhood. It speaks about the influences that you may have had growing up. It also speaks about emotions that have not been yet dealt with. It also speaks about complexes. It speaks about how it is that you are reacting to a certain situation, still moving out of old patterns and old thoughts. And Saturn is there to help you to change. She is, yes, a very tough taskmaster. And a lot of people, unfortunately, fear Saturn, saying that I get a lot of interesting mails asking me that, when is it finally that Saturn is going to be leaving my chart? And when do I finally get rid of Saturn out of my chart? But the truth is that Saturn never really leaves the chart, so to speak. She merely moves the house. She shifts her gaze onto another part of the house that may require attention or may require change at that point of time. And for you Sagittarians, this shift is there into things that are very important on an emotional level. I think there is a lot of cleaning that needs to be done. There is a lot of letting go that needs to be done. Also, I think the interesting thing is it speaks also of childhood issues. It speaks of emotions that you have not as yet dealt with are still there on the subconscious. These are all part of your growing up, I think, and these are what have sort of formed you today. There could be a certain fear, there could be insecurities, complexities, which are just somehow holding you back, and these could be because of the beliefs that you have had in your formative years. So Saturn is asking you now, and she's going to be applying pressure, and it is not always a very pleasant experience, but then the idea is for you to change. I think none of us are very happy changing. We are quite comfortable the way we are and the way we perceive ourselves to be, but with Saturn being there, and Saturn is going to be pushing you, and she's going to be ensuring that you change for the better. For the next 2.5 years, Sagittarians, you are going to be put under the microscope, and Saturn is going to ensure that you go to the blackboard and you do your lessons right. And I think it's something quite brilliant. In fact, it is said that every time Saturn leaves your house, a particular house, she always leaves a beautiful gift for you, and that gift lasts for life. So look at it as a foundation time really for yourself. Look at it as a time where you are sort of cleaning the cupboard for good. You're getting rid of things that are no longer required, emotions that are no longer required, ideas, concepts, beliefs, thoughts, patterns that you have grown up with, which are no longer serving any purpose to you. So I think that that is something that you need to really let go of now, Sagittarians. Also, the 12th is the house of karma. It is about what you sow, so you shall reap. So be careful also about this time, Sagittarians. Stay on the right side of the law. Try not to get involved in unscrupulous dealings. Try not to get involved with people or in things that are underhand. Try not to cheat, lie, cross your friends, try not to do things that are not with the law of universe. Stay on the right side of the law of universe for the next 2.5 years, Sagittarians, and for sure Saturn will benefit you. I think you just need to work with the energy of Saturn and not get quite scared and worried about it. I think it's really a time wherein that you need to be willing to be making the change, you know, rather than fearing it. Let go of the fear. There's nothing really to worry about. Also, it is a time that a lot of you may not feel like socializing, and like 12th house is not really a house where you want to jump with joy and you want to go out and you want to party. So it's quite all right if you feel that you want to be, you know, with yourself, you just want to spend a lot of time with yourself. I think it's quite fine. Use this time to, whether it is to read, research, or anything that is behind the scene work. If you don't want to be on the front, it is quite all right, I think. But for those of you who are younger and who are really on to the space where, of course, parting is very imperative, you could feel a bit restrained and you could feel a tad frustrated, as Saturn can be confining and she can be quite limiting and restricting. So you could find that space a bit challenged, but for the older lot of you, I think you would be quite happy spending this time by yourself. And like I said, it's a great time to be reading up, understanding things that you have maybe wanted to know more about. So it's quite all right not to be socializing during this time. Also, this aspect lasts for you for 2.5 years, Sagittarians. So try not to get too depressed or lonely, and try not to sort of overanalyze things. It's a good time to be, again, trying your hand at meditation. For those of you who have not as yet tried it, I strongly recommend it. And especially with your 12th house in focus, I think it will benefit you a lot. A lot of you would also want to get involved with an NGO, or you may want to do something more, more for charity. So it's a great time to be getting involved in giving back, sort of. It's a good place to serve. When your 12th house comes in focus, it's really a time to serve, Sagittarians. So it's a time of giving. Try not to be in a mode of, what is it that I get in turn if I were to be doing this? I think for the next 2.5 years, serve. Try and help out as much as you can without expectations. The goodness will come back to you in many, many forms. So have a great October. I'll see you again in November. And thank you so much for watching.